Hi students, how are you? In this session, now we are going to discuss about colligative properties. Here, colligative properties means the properties of dilute solution which depends only on number of solute particles. Such a properties are called as colligative properties. Means these properties only depends on number of solute particles present in solution. These properties does not depending on size of solute particle, nature of solute particle, chemical composition of solute particle. So such a properties of solutions we call as colligative properties. Here some colligative properties we are going to see. Names first, RLVP is nothing but relative lowering of vapor pressure. This is the first colligative property. Second one, elevation of boiling point. Depression in freezing point. Fourth one, osmotic pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation of boiling point, this is we can denoted with delta TB. Elevation is nothing but increasing in boiling point. Depression in freezing point, this is denoted with delta TF. F indicate freezing point. Here delta TF, decreasing in freezing point or depression in freezing point. Fourth one, here osmotic pressure, it is denoted with the symbol pi. Is it clear? These are colligative properties. Here these colligative properties mainly depends on number of solute particles present in solution. Whatever the solute is present, if number of solute particles same, their colligative property value is almost equal. Here this colligative property is directly proportional to number of solute particles. At the same time, colligative property inversely proportional to molar mass of solute. Molar mass of solute decreases, what will happen? So here number of moles, if formula n equal to mass of solute by molar mass of solute. Molar mass, if mass some constant, if we take here molar mass decreases, number of moles of solute particles increases. Number of solute particle increases, it is colligative property value also increases. So your colligative property directly proportional to number of solute particle. In the same way, colligative property value inversely proportional to molar mass of solute. Molar mass decreases, overall number of, in particular quantity of solute, number of solute particles increases, therefore colligative property value increases. So briefly once again, colligative property means the property of dilute solution which depends only on number of solute particle present in the solution, that is we call colligative properties. One by one we have to see detailed Now we are seeing relative lowering of vapor pressure. Before going into this relative lowering of vapor pressure, briefly how to see what is vapor pressure, what is lowering of vapor pressure, what is relative lowering of vapor pressure, one by one you have to see. First is see, sir, in this container some amount of pure solvent I am taken. On this surface area only solvent molecules are occupied. Which solvent molecules having a high kinetic energy, they try to escape into next empty space as a vapor molecules. So here liquid, in this process liquid turns to vapor. Which are having high kinetic energy, that molecule convert into vapor. After some time, due to collisions between vapor molecules, that vapor molecules also start convert into liquid phase. Is it clean? This is forward direction. Liquid convert into vapor. It is called rate of vaporization. And vapor molecule convert into liquid molecule. This process, we call condensation. Means per unit time, how much molecules convert into liquid, that is rate of condensation. Per unit time, how many liquid molecule convert into vapor, that is we call rate of vaporization. The time at which rate of vaporization equal to rate of condensation, that is we called, what's it? State of equilibrium. At the equilibrium, the pressure exerted by the vapor molecules of liquid is called vapor pressure. That is we call vapor pressure. Here there is no solute molecule, only solvent molecule is there. This is pure component. So pure solvent vapor pressure. Here this is what we call pure solvent vapor pressure, we are denoted with P naught. Pure solvent, generally solvent means one, solute means two. Pure solvent means we can take like this, P1 naught means pure solvent vapor pressure. Is it clear? Now you see, sir, for this same amount of pure solvent at the same temperature, when we are adding some amount of non-volatile and non-electrolyte solute, this solute particle dissolve into the solvent and surface area, some fraction of surface area occupied by even this solute particle. These solute particles are non-volatile, non-vaporized. On the surface area, fraction of solvent particles decreases. So here, compared to pure solvent, in solution, surface pure solvent molecules are less. That's why vaporization nature also decreases. Is it clean? Here, vaporization nature decreases. Here also, after some time, in between rate of vaporization, rate of condensation, speed will be equal. The state we called equilibrium state. At equilibrium state, the pressure exerted by the solution we called, that is vapor pressure of solution. We can denote it with P1. Vapor pressure of solution P1. Vapor pressure of pure solvent P1 naught. Sir, why one we are using? In this solution, both solute plus solvent is there, but solute not vaporized. This vapor pressure only contributed by the solvent molecule in the solution. That's why P1 we are using. Vapor pressure of solute is zero, so that is we can't take vapor pressure of solution. Means vapor pressure of solution means in solution solvent molecules only vaporized. That solvent molecule contributed pressure is nothing but vapor pressure of solution. Carefully see comparison between vapor pressure of pure solvent, vapor pressure of solution. P1 naught, P1, which is more, which is less? Sir, simple. In pure solvent, surface area only solvent molecules are there. So escaping nature of solvent molecule here more. In solution, here fraction of fraction of solvent molecules and area occupied, the some fraction of area of solvent molecules reduced. In the same way, vaporization nature of solvent molecule in solution decreases. Therefore, vaporization decreases, vapor pressure also decreases. Simply, pure solvent vaporization more, vapor pressure more. When non-volatile solute added, vaporization decreases, vapor pressure decreases. Based on that, for any solution containing non-volatile solute, its vapor pressure always less than vapor pressure of pure solvent. Therefore, P1 naught greater than P1. What is P1 naught? Vapor pressure of pure solvent, vapor pressure of solution. In any solution, vapor pressure of pure solvent is more than vapor pressure of solution containing non-volatile solute. Is it clear? So pure solvent vapor pressure more, solution vapor pressure is less. It means what we are understanding, for pure solvent, if you dissolve non-volatile solute, vapor pressure decreases. That decreasing vapor pressure from here to here, that is we called lowering of vapor pressure. Next one, what's it? Lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure, this is we can denote it with delta P, where delta P is equal to the vapor the difference in vapor pressure of pure solvent and vapor pressure of solution is called lowering of vapor pressure. You have to see delta P is equal to P1 naught minus P1. Lowering of vapor pressure is defined as, it is the difference between vapor pressure of pure solvent and vapor pressure of solution is known as lowering of vapor pressure. Next, come to the main point, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Here, relative lowering of vapor pressure is defined as, it is the ratio of lowering of vapor pressure to the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to delta P by P1 naught. It is the ratio of delta P by P1 naught. What is delta P? It is lowering of vapor pressure by vapor pressure of pure solvent. Carefully see, here delta P means what we can write? P1 naught minus P1 by P1 naught. This is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Here three words we are seeing. What that is? Vapor pressure of pure solvent, P1 naught. Vapor pressure of solution, P1. Next, here second point, vapor pressure of pure solvent always greater than vapor pressure of solution which contain non-volatile solute. Next, second point, you come lowering of vapor pressure. It is the difference between vapor pressure of pure solvent and vapor pressure of solution. Last one, relative lowering of vapor pressure. It is the ratio of lowering of vapor pressure to the vapor pressure of pure solvent. Here you see, relative lowering of vapor pressure we are understanding. Now, according to Raoult's law, come to the Raoult's law. According to Raoult's law, in solution, vapor pressure of each volatile component is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Based on that, P1 proportional to X1, or P1 is equal to P1 naught into X1. P1 equal to P1 naught into X1. P1 means already you know, vapor pressure of solution, P1 naught, vapor pressure of pure solvent, X1, mole fraction of solvent. This is we consider as point 1. Now come to the lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure, that is delta P is equal to P1 naught minus P1. Here, this is equation 2. Shall we substitute equation 1 in equation 2? Substitute equation 1 in equation 2. Here P1 value, how to substitute here? What we are getting? Delta P is equal to P1 naught minus, here what we can write? P1 naught into x1. Here P1 common is there, so you take common P1. Delta P is equal to, what's that? Delta P is equal to P1 of x1, sorry, 1 minus x1. 1 minus x1 is equal to what? It become x2. Therefore, delta P by P1 naught is equal to 1 minus x. 1 minus x1 is equal to x2. 1 minus mole fraction of solvent is equal to mole fraction of solute. Therefore, your delta P means P1 naught minus P1 by P1 naught is equal to x2, where x2 is nothing but mole fraction of solute. How to write? Number of moles of solute by number of moles of solvent plus solute. This is what, sir? According to Raoult's law, relative lowering of vapor pressure, RLVP, P0 minus P1 by P0, P1 naught is equal to RLVP. According to Raoult's law, relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute, not solvent, mole fraction of solute. This is applicable for very dilute solutions. In very dilute solution, number of moles of solute is very less as compared to number of moles of solvent. In this case, in denominator, once you observed your number of moles of solvent, number of moles of solute, number of moles of solute here negligible as compared to N1, or number of moles of solvent. Therefore, instead of N1 plus N2, we can take only N1. Reason, this is negligible. So instead of N1 plus N2 equal to N1. Therefore, now come to here. So if you neglect P1 naught minus P1 by P1 naught is equal to number of moles of solute by number of moles of solvent. Is it clear? Now if you write P1 naught minus P1 by P1 naught is equal to N1, N2 means number of moles of solute. 2 or B, both indicate solute. 1 or A indicate solvent. Based on that, you see, N2 means number of moles of solute. Number of moles of solute means mass of solute by molar mass of solute. Into by is then, so molar mass of solvent by mass of solvent is a clean. So from this, we can separate molar mass of solute is equal to W2 into M1 by W1. Into this part you take into that side. So what's that? P1 naught by P1 naught minus P1, or it is 1 by RLVP. So this is the formula. Here, by using relative lowering of vapor pressure, we can estimate or we can determine molar mass of solute. In generally, these colligative properties are more useful to determine the molar mass of unknown solute present in the solution. Based on that molar mass of solute, we can estimate which solute is present in given solution. Is it clear? So what we are doing, sir, is relative lowering of vapor pressure. First, that meaning, see, it is the ratio of lowering of vapor pressure to the low vapor pressure of pure solvent. This is what's relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now comes to the Raoult's law. According to Raoult's law, here vapor pressure of each volatile component in the solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. So vapor pressure of solvent directly proportional to mole fraction of solvent. So from that, to remove the proportionality, I wrote here proportionality constant P1 naught. Here P1 naught is vapor pressure of pure solvent, vapor pressure of solution, mole fraction of solvent. Lowering of vapor pressure, already we seen, it is the difference between vapor pressure of pure solvent and vapor pressure of solution. If the P1 if you substituted here, finally what we are getting, sir, delta P is equal to P1 naught minus P1 naught into X1. Here we are separating, we are taking common P1 naught. The from this delta P by P1 naught, delta P by P1 naught is equal to X2, mole fraction of solute. Here delta P by P1 naught, already you know that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Is it clear? Relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to what's that? Mole fraction of solute. Okay, na? Mole fraction of solute means it is the number of moles of solute by total number of moles of all component in the solution. For very dilute solution, remember, very important, for very dilute solution, number of moles of solute is very very less. And for very dilute solution, N1 double greater than N2, therefore N2 is negligible. Now we are getting N2 by N1, number of moles of solute, mass of solute by molar mass of solute, by mass of solvent by molar mass of solvent, that is we can write here mass of solvent by molar mass of solvent. If you want to calculate molar mass of solute, M2 we can separate from this formula. So what we are getting, sir, M2 is equal to W2 into M1 by W1 into P01 by P01 minus P1. Sir, here it indicate M2 is equal to W2 by M1 by W1 of 1 by RLVP. Suppose instead of P1 naught and P1 values, if they given direct RLVP, 1 by RLVP you have to take to find the what's that molecular mass of unknown solute present in the solution. This is what's that relative lowering of vapor pressure. Is it clear? Based on by applying Raoult's law, finally what we are getting in this relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute. This is the formula to calculate molar mass of solute present in the solution. Next one, second colligative property, that is elevation of boiling point, denoted with delta suffix B and delta T suffix B. Delta simply we called delta TB is nothing but elevation of boiling point. Sir, what, first before going to this concept, what is boiling point we have to see. Boiling point, the temperature at which vapor pressure of the solution is equal to atmospheric pressure is called boiling point. Which solutions having more vaporizing nature, their boiling points are less. Which solutions having less vaporizing nature, their boiling points are high. Carefully see to understand this one. Boiling point, boiling temperature, the temperature at which vapor pressure of the solution is equal to atmospheric pressure. In generally, atmospheric pressure, what we can take 1 atmosphere or 1.013 bars. This is we consider as atmospheric pressure. So the temperature at which vapor pressure of solution equal to this pressure, it is called boiling temperature. Sir, here I am taken pure solvent in second case, that pure solvent containing solute. So this is not called solution. Solution containing non-volatile non-volatile solute. Sir, here in pure solvent already we seen two times. Here is a pure solvent on surface area, only solvent particles are there. So solvent particle here, more solvent particle occupy surfacing area, surface area. That's why escaping nature of solvent particles here very high. So here vapor pressure also high. So vapor pressure is more, therefore easily it can reaches what, sir? Its vapor pressure equal to atmospheric pressure. So this, the temperature at which vapor pressure of pure solvent equal to atmospheric pressure, that is we called boiling point of pure solvent. This boiling point we can denote it with delta TB naught, boiling point of pure solvent, not indicate pure substance, boiling point of pure solvent delta TB naught, the temperature at which this pure solvent vapor pressure equal to 1 atmosphere pressure, that is what we call sir, vapor pressure of pure solvent TB naught. For this pure solvent, in this second diagram I added some amount of solute, means on surface area some fraction of surface area occupied by solute particle. These solute particles are not vaporized, reason these are non-volatile particle. In this surface area some fraction only occupies solvent particle, these are ready to escape. But as compared to first one, pure solvent, in solution vaporization nature is less. Here solution boiling point means the temperature at which this vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure, that is we call solution boiling point. Actually here vaporization nature is less, vapor pressure less. To reach this 1 atmosphere pressure, here more temperature is required. If you give more heat energy, temperature increases, more solvent particle try to escape. Is it clear? As compared to this one, here solution boiling point is higher. This solution boiling point we consider as TB. Reason why this TB is higher than TB naught? Here non-volatile solute particles are there. Solvent molecule escaping nature is less. Vapor pressure is less. That's why vapor pressure to increase, where we have to supply more heat energy. While supplying heat energy, your temperature also increases. Therefore, in any solution, boiling point, so any solution boiling point is less than its pure solvent. Therefore, here TB greater than TB naught. Boiling point of solution containing non-volatile electrolyte is higher than boiling point of its pure solvent. Simple, number of solute particle or number of non-volatile solute particle increases, therefore its boiling point value increases. Is a clean based on that. Now come to the delta TB. Delta TB, what we call elevation of boiling point, or it also consider increasing in boiling point. Is a clean. Elevation of boiling point is defined as, it is the difference between boiling point of solution and boiling point of pure solvent. Delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. Here in general, you know already, boiling point of solution higher than boiling point of pure solvent. This difference only we called elevation of boiling point. Now come to the graph lines. Vapor pressure versus temperature. Sir, you see, here first one, pure solvent I taken. 2, solution 1. This line belongs to solution 2. Pure solvent vapor pressure P naught, solution 1 vapor pressure P1, solution 2 vapor pressure P2. Is it clear? With increasing temperature, vapor pressure is also increases. Carefully see, the temperature at which your vapor pressure of pure solvent or solution equal to atmospheric pressure, that is 1 atmosphere, is called boiling point. This is the boiling point of pure solvent, TB naught. Okay, now yet see, sir, your boiling point of solution 1, TB1, boiling point of solution 2, TB2. Is it clear? This is the boiling points, temperatures. Boiling point of pure solvent always less than boiling point of solution 1 and boiling point of solution 2. Sir, here I am applying according to elevation of boiling point principle. According to elevation of boiling point principle, here carefully see, sir, in this case, your boiling point, this difference, the ratio of vapor pressure P naught minus P1 by P naught 1 minus P2 is equal to, is the ratio of difference in vapor pressure or lowering in vapor pressure equal to TB1 minus TB0 suffix you write, sir. 1, 2. TB2 minus TB0. Based on this, carefully see, the ratio of lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the difference in a ratio of elevation of boiling points. Based on this, what we can write? Your delta P proportional to delta TB. Vapor pressure of difference in vapor pressure, lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to elevation of boiling point. Now one more point. According to Raoult's law, you know already, vapor pressure of solution directly proportional to its mole fraction. Here you see mole fraction difference. According to Raoult's law, the vapor pressure of lowering of vapor pressure directly proportional to mole fraction of solvent. Here this is point 1, this is point 2, this is point 1. From equation 1 and 2, what we are getting? Delta TB is directly proportional to x1. Sorry, listen carefully, you have to see. Lowering of vapor pressure means solute particle increases, vapor pressure, lowering of vapor pressure increase means delta P proportional to x2 is here. Therefore, lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. According to from equation 1 and 2, delta TB is proportional to mole fraction of solute. Carefully see, to remove this one, your proportionality constant, delta TB is equal to K into K into X2. Here K is nothing but proportionality constant. Therefore, delta TB is equal to K into number of moles of solute by, number of moles of solute by total number of moles of solvent plus solute. Carefully see, for a dilute solution, for very dilute solution, means number of moles of solute is very less, therefore N1 double greater than N2, then what we are getting, delta TB is equal to K into N2 by N1. N2 by N1. Here carefully see, delta B is equal to K into N2, means mass of solute by molar mass of solute into N, molar mass of solvent by mass of solvent. This is the equation we are getting. So this is in another format I am writing, just M1 I am writing here. Delta TB K into M1 into W2 by M2, shall we write here direct number of moles of solute, N2 by W1. Sir, if W1 condition, if W1 is equal to 1 kc, then N2 by W1 is equal to molality. Why, sir? N2 is nothing but number of moles of solute. W1 value 1 kg means number of moles of solute present in 1 kg solvent we call molality. So in the place of N2 by W1 we can write what, sir? Molality. In the place of K into M1 we can write KB. See here, in the place of K into M1, what, delta TB is equal to K into M1 is nothing but KB into here, this is what, sir, small m here, therefore delta TB is equal to KB into molality. According to this, here elevation of boiling point directly proportional to molality. Elevation of boiling point of solution directly proportional to molality. Carefully see, sir, what we are seeing here already, you know, depression, lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to, according to graph, delta P directly proportional to delta TB. And according to Raoult's law, lowering of vapor pressure increases with increasing number of solute particle. From equation, delta P directly proportional to delta TB, delta P proportional to X2. From these two, delta TB proportional to X2, mole fraction of solute, delta TB equal to K into X2. Here X2 means mole fraction of solute, we wrote like that. For very dilute solution, N2 is neglected. So equation we are getting like this. Now if we extended this one, W2 by M2 into M1 by W1. Here this M1 I am writing here, N2, W2 by M2 is writing as usual N2, and W1 I am taken like this. This is a clean one. Here number of moles of solute by mass of solvent. If mass of solvent is 1 kc, number of moles of solute present in 1 kc solvent is equal to molality. That is only here I substituted. Is a clean one. Now come to the here delta TB equal to KB into molality. Now what is KB? Here KB is proportionality constant. This KB we called elevation constant or molal elevation constant, molal elevation constant or ubilioscopic constant. Different names are there, elevation constant or molal elevation constant, ebullioscopic constant. Carefully see, sir. The units, this KB value is constant for given each solvent. Every solvent possessing particular, here particular constant, ebullioscopic constant value. Units of KB. Units of KB. KB units, if you want, means what we are getting? Delta TB by molality. Delta TB means measured in kelvins. By molality means here what, sir? Mole per kg. Mole per kg. If you go take into numerator, what you're getting? Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. Kelvin, kg, mole inverse is the KB units. KB value is constant for given solvent. Suppose for water, KB value 0.52 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Suppose ethanol C2H5OH, KB value 1.2 Kelvin kg mole inverse. For benzene C6H6, KB value 1.53 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Carefully see, ebullioscopic constant value for each solvent is constant. This value not changes. Carefully see, here delta TB is directly proportional to molality of the solution according to this equation. Okay, now calculation of molar mass of solvent, molar mass of solute from elevation of boiling point, that is nothing but delta TB. Already we know major relation, delta TB is equal to KB into molality. Molality is nothing but number of moles of solute present in 1 kg solvent. You expand this equation, KB into molality, mass of solute by molar mass of solute. B indicate, BR2 indicate solute, by into 1000 by mass of solvent in grams. Suppose kgs is there, 1 by volume of solvent, mass of solvent in kgs. Sir, if you want to calculate, this is separate. MB, molar mass of solute. Molar mass of solute is equal to KB into WB into 1000 by delta TB into mass of solvent in grams. Here delta MB is equal to molar mass of this is what, sir? Molar mass of solute present in solution equal to KB, ebullioscopic constant, into mass of solute into 1000 by elevation of boiling point into mass of solvent in grams. By using this formula, we can calculate unknown solute molar mass which is present in the solution. Next one. Here, now calculation of molar elevation constant KB. Here KB, how to calculate? That formula you see, sir, then it KB is equal to 1000 into TB naught square by KB is equal to R TB naught square by 1000 into LV. Here L suffix V. LV means here we can write like this. L suffix V. Latent heat of vaporization. Sir, in the place of LV, here since LV is equal to enthalpy of vaporization by molar mass of solvent. If you substituted in this place, KB is equal to RTB naught square by 1000 into delta H of vaporization by, means come to here, what's a molar mass of solvent. What are the terms present here, you see, sir? KB already know, ebullioscopic constant, or molar elevation constant, or what is R? Universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. TB naught, boiling point of pure solvent. Boiling point of pure solvent. M1, molar mass of solvent. M1 is molar mass of solvent. Here LV, enthalpy of, or latent heat, enthalpy, better what? Latent heat of vaporization per gram. Latent heat of vaporization per gram. Latent heat of vaporization per gram of, per gram solvent. In the same way, delta H, enthalpy of vaporization per 1 mole of solvent. Here per 1 gram, this is 1 mole. So this 1 mole to 1 mole heat of vaporization, from this to get the heat latent heat of vaporization for 1 gram, this delta H vaporization by what we can take, molar mass of solvent, is a clean. This enthalpy of vaporization of solvent per 1 mole, your latent heat of vaporization per 1 gram. Simply remember, latent heat of vaporization equal to enthalpy of vaporization by molar mass of solvent. That is only substituted here. If these all values provided, we can calculate what's the KB value. In maximum problems, KB constant value they will provide in examinations, is a clean. So remaining colligative properties, that is depression in freezing point and osmotic pressure, will continue in next session. Okay, thank you.